Dr. Kim Hammond here with Levi to answer your pet questions from Falls Road Animal Hospital. How are you?
I am fantastic. And Levi is a two-year-old kind of peak cocker. It's kind of eavesdropping on a Pekingese or eavesdropping on a cocker. I'm not sure what we're eavesdropping on, but it's not 100%. Maybe we might do a DNA test one day just for fun.
All right.
And a cool dog. And you know where this dog was found, which is really interesting if you're looking for a new dog. This dog was found by a young woman named Emma on Craigslist.
Yeah,
someone was getting rid of their dog on Craigslist, so she found her dog on Craigslist.
And
that's
what a find.
New way to look for doggies, Craigslist.
Yeah, very sweet. How about some questions?
Okay.
This one's from Facebook. A Facebook viewer just bought a 8-week-old mini dachshund. She wants to know how to get her trained to go outside and when she'll start to pick up on her name.
You know, first of all, you can start the name now. And the way you do it, it's, you know, there are a lot of different ways to train dogs. You know, get a good book or find a training place close to you and follow that particular way, because there's so many different ways. So pick one way and follow it. Dachshunds are fun to train, but a mini dachshund is the size of your palm,
yeah,
for God's sake. Going outside for a mini dachshund is like going to the other side of the rug.
It's
just so hard.
You have to get them comfortable with
you
that.
Do. So you have to really, there's a way to house train them. There's a book by Mark Katz on house training, and if you call 539-3044, you can get it, and I would follow his way.
Okay, cool.
All right.
Here's another question. This one's from John. He has a 12-year-old cat who started having seizures. When it happens, he rolls around on the floor to the point that he's urinating. John's very concerned and wants to know why this is happening.
I'd be very concerned too. And that's not an easy diagnosis. I'd go to your veterinarian, first of all, check out, make sure there's no liver problems and things like that. And barring a normal, you know, if you find a normal exam, maybe go see a neurologist. In town, there is a great veterinary neurologist named Larry Gainsburg. He's in Cadenceville. But I would not delay.
Okay.
I would not delay on
that. Yeah, that sounds really scary.
Yeah, it's really scary on a 12-year-old cat.
Thank you, Dr. Kim. Appreciate you being here. Thank you, Levi.